first blood.
That was but the first taste of revenge.
Silence! Greetings! Disagree with your alliance.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
A prize!
My wings are broken.
Yeah.
The problem is you're never going to finish it until you want to become fully six slotted.
Yeah. Kinda. I think maybe fifth item is fine.
Dendi and Koitva. They're so close, but that's the vision of the Radiant side, that's the vision of the Dire side. So they see Dendi. Ult stomp up. They need a little bit more control, and the Ravage will provide that. Just Na'Vi now want to try and push while this is on the sideline. Especially when they see Bulba walking past the Observer Ward. So it's going to be a one-for-one trade-off if Bulba can't get out. VS swapping him back and into the duel.
They can also just type.
Fnatic wants some help here in the mid lane. He'll need it too. The Park Orb, he jumps up. He can't get the body block off. Now Sing Sing, Avalanche, they go with a return Gush. There will be the toss back and Funny. He's already got the Blade Mail up, and then the Mystic Flare from Bulba will get the kill. So they do manage to finally end that killing spree. Well, they want to go for more. Sing Sing tosses a barbell. He wants to throw an EGM, but he got the range creep instead while the hoof stomp from Pycat. A little bit of target. Then he jumps himself back in to initiate with a Vorce. They pick off Bulba as that Skywrath Mage. EGM, he's got bugs on him, which is not helping. That negative armor is really dropping him low. He needs to relocate, save them out. Successful timing. The Avalanche is meant to buy him that time, too. And EGM has to sacrifice himself. He can't come with Sing Sing. I'm sorry, EGM. Your life shall be over. A Vorce waits for him, this done, and it's just too easy. We're on Legion Commander, but if you get caught with your pants down, like for example, here, Funnik, the relocate, it's gonna come. They wanna have a crack at Funnik, they need more help. There's that BKB gonna trigger. How much damage do they really have? He turns the Blade Mail on, and Pycat hurting himself, the Dream Core gonna hold him here, and Funnik starts the duel. Sing Sing, he needs more damage. The BKB has now worn off, and the relocate actually pulls him back up towards the middle lane, and leaves Koifa for himself, and same with Bulba. Now they really want to leave him there, but for the quick kill on the Legion Commander. And now you got a massive problem, and that's Roshan. Sure, you do actually...
They can still fight this time.
Yeah, they can, because they've double Ravage. Sing Sing, there's your Avalanche Toss combo. Looking for the cleave, the stun. Where is this Tidehunter? The Ravage, he does it from the high ground. Now bleeds himself in to get the secondary Ravage. Kills off Ogre. He'll kill off the Vengeful Spirit as well. But you got the Tiny on the sideline. The Hoofstop to ensure the VS does die.
He just walks back afterwards.
Well, they can go on middle lane then. Centaur ulti, VS not going to cancel that. Skywrath Mage going to die in the meantime up on the top lane. And Pycat trying to move down the Funnik. Now it's time to duel. He kills off. In towards the middle lane, Funnik. Waiting for the right jump target. The Aegis Maul has only got 2 minutes left on it. And now Pycat, they found Funnik in the tree line with the Gush and the Avalanche tossing him in. VS looking for the swap. He actually pulled Pycat out of this one. The Vanskull gonna melt inside the Mystic Flare. The duel is on right now. Funnik, he does become a winner, but he might lose directly after. They both blink after him. A Vorce, how much damage? Hoofstomp, he's got timeline still available. Is he gonna get it off in time? And the answer is yes. He's able to get it off, which means a Vorce can now move over to Bulba. Then he will die in the meantime. Bulba, 5 life points. Escaping out, the orb will fly, but the Sentry Wall still reveals him. The Aegis Immortal will go. The toss is off cooldown right now. Koifa doesn't have himself anything. They toss the Vorce up. Remember, there's still no time lapse. Bulba, for some reason, he stuck around just for the seal. Sing Sing needs more damage, and they got it. The double kill comes in for Sing Sing.
He just goes for that bottom tower, mid tower. While bottom lane, Na'Vi, they push. There's no fortification because they use it to defend their middle lane, and they've got to come back to defend right now. Sing Sing, no way to jump in. Koifa, he's got his ulti up, but now he sees the BKB triggered off by Funnik. Remember, it's a low duration, but they've already brought down the range track. The Vorce wants to finish up the melee. He gets avalanched up. He wants to still finish the job here, but who's he going? He needs to come back to find the heroes. Koifa still got this Ravage available. Vanskull, low on life. Pycat can't finish the job, and Koifa still can't find a good target. They get through the Aegis, the Immortal. That's the Weaver coming back to life again. The stun onto Koifa. Weaver, the BKB will go for the cleave damage. There's your duel. Finally bringing down the Tides. There was no second Ravage.
but they don't get the melee Rex. They're trying to retreat back out, healing up Vanskor. Will they go back in?
Here. And Sing Sing, Kenny getting close. There's your swap, the Hex. They're going to bring him down. The relocate, it's not, it is a relocate save, but not in time. Sing Sing will drop, he'll buy back in. They must hold this bottom Rex. Still not brought down by the rest of Na'Vi, while Pycat dropping low in life. Now your Avalanche, toss combo, needs to cleave, but the timelapse back off cooldown. Another follow-up solo to Sing Sing, funning, not even getting the duel off. It's coming off cooldown in 5 seconds time. At the BKB, it was his second duration on that one. Dendi, off stomp, it catches him. One swing from Sing Sing, well, he tosses the dead corpse of Dendi up and towards the air. And they need to chase further. Toss, 3 seconds away. That'll throw Pycat onto the retreating Ogre Magi, who needs to try and turn and stun right now. He doesn't have mana for it, so he tosses, in fact, the Wisp. He does get the Avalanche toss out, but
no way,
Dendi, well, man. Okay, Dendi, silence on three heroes. He's sticking around Dagon. It's off cooldown. He wants to kill off Sing Sing. They turn around Funnik. The duel is available. He wants Sing Sing. Try and catch up to him. Now he can. The duel into Sing Sing. 2 minutes on the sideline. Pycat into the tree lines as well. The Park Orb, as much damage as possible. EGM down. Pycat, no saving grace. He's stuck in the trees where it is not safe to be. 100 seconds on the side. Well, Funnik wants to jump. Blink Dagger up. He doesn't have duel right now. He will get the Misty Flare dropped on him. Ravage as well, tanking up the tier 4 towers. In fact, Dendi, but they've already brought down the mid. So they forced out the Ravage as well as the Mystic Flare.
Now they kill top lane.
Yeah.
He just can't stop them.
He knew he was going to survive anyway.
Yeah. He had the bench for being ready for it.
And that full Butterfly is over on the Weaver now. So no direct damage. Tani picks up a Mask of Madness. It's kind of YOLO. They need to hold up the towers. Funnik with the BKB. He wants to blink and duel. He's going to find the target. And it's Koifa. Look at that damage output from the Legion. Plus 178 from a GG is the call. Game number one here will go to Na'Vi, giving him a 2-0 advantage because of the winner's bracket advantage. Team Tinker, they are facing up against what no team ever wants to face up. They have to get 3 consecutive wins against Na'Vi on land in order to win this grand final.
This is going to be really tough for them.
It will
be. They need, I don't know, I think they need better drafts, honestly.